Yeah, we have just learned about Fabric as a nice alternative to the Lightning Trainer, which only requires a few lines of code that we need to change. So let's actually try this out in practice and train a large language model using Fabric.
All right, let's now convert this PyTorch script for training a large language model into a script that uses Fabric so that we can scale it up to multiple GPUs and use all the little tips and tricks like mixed precision training that we introduced in unit 9. So here I have a PyTorch script training this DistilBERT model that we trained already in unit 8. The difference is that we are not using the trainer here. So this script here I'm showing you on the right hand side is essentially a script that just uses regular PyTorch. So this is similar to what we have done in unit 4 a long time ago. So how I organize this is that we are first importing everything. We have a tokenized text function that we already used in unit 9. And then I set up this training function here that takes several arguments for the the different training and validation orders, the device, whether it's a CPU or GPU, the model itself, the optimizer, and then we can also specify the number of epochs. So here we are using torch metrics to compute the accuracy, the training accuracy, and also later on the validation accuracy further below. So what we do here is we are, of course, setting our model into the training mode. Then we iterate over the batches in the training loader. So that's been a long time ago, but that's what we've done manually in unit 4. Then usually the model and the data have to be on the same device. So we are doing that later. I will show you where we put the model onto the GPU, but we have to do the same thing here also for the training data. So here we are putting the training data onto the same device where the model will sit on later. So then we are getting the outputs from the model, and the outputs contain various things like the last layer outputs, but also the loss. And that is because we are using this DistilBERT model from the transformers library. So we will get to that in a few moments, what this model looks like exactly. But for the moment here, the model returns outputs. And then we are using the zero grad methods on the optimizer to reset the gradients, and then call backward on the loss function to do the backpropagation. So again, it's been a long time since we used a PyTorch in this very manual version, that is unit 4. So after unit 4, we only used the trainer, so we didn't have to worry about these things. But it's actually useful to be familiar with that, because that sometimes when you, let's say, go on GitHub, you may discover scripts that use pure PyTorch, and it's useful to understand it so that you can then manually change it to using Fabric or the trainer. So we are calling the optimizer step to apply the gradient updates. And then we have some logging here to just show the training progress. Now here we have the evaluation part where we are doing the calculation of the accuracy for the training set, also for the validation set. So actually we are doing the validation accuracy here, and then we are iterating again over the different data points in the training loader, put everything onto the GPU, and then do basically the validation accuracy computation here, and then we log the results here. So this is the training function that I mentioned, and further below here is the main function that gets called when we are executing that script. So what the main function here is doing, it's first outputting some basic statistics using our favorite watermark package. Then we are setting the random number generator seed here to generate reproducible training runs. If you want to run this again, you will get the same results. We are loading the data set, so I'm using some functions that we already used in unit 9, so I don't want to, let's say, discuss this in detail, otherwise the video will be way too long, and we already covered that previously. The tokenizer and everything, same as in unit 8 and 9. And the interesting part is further down here where we initialize the model, put it on the GPU, initialize our optimizer, and then train the model using the training function, which we just discussed above. And we will let it train, and then after the training, compute the test accuracy, and be done with that. So this is a regular PyTorch script. We can run this here in Visual Studio Code, and it might take a long time. It might take, I would say, on a GPU, half an hour, 45 minutes or something like that. So depends, of course, on what type of GPU you're using. But this can be very slow because it's training on a single GPU, and we are not using mixed precision training here. What we want to do now is we want to see how we can use Fabric to speed that up by better utilizing our hardware without making, let's say, many modifications to our code. So I will, in a few moments, I will just show you that the training here indeed works. In a few moments, I will change this script into using Fabric, and then we can train this model pretty efficiently in a few, let's say, minutes. So yeah, you can see it's training now. It will take a long time. Since we are not using Fabric, we also don't have a progress bar here. So all we see is basically the print function that we used, where it's printing the progress here one by one, or line by line. Let me actually interrupt this because it will take way too long, and then we will change our script to using Fabric. So we will start at the top, and I will show you the different modifications we have to make. So I would say the first thing, of course, is importing Fabric. So we say from Lightning import Fabric. And then we are going to do a few small changes here in the train function. So when we use Fabric, we use actually Fabric device now instead of using device directly. So we will also have to supply it here in the function inputs. What's nice though is that we don't necessarily need to put the data onto the device ourselves anymore. Fabric will take care of it for us. We will just have to set up the data loaders using Fabric further below. But what that means is we can simplify the code here. We can just get rid of these two lines of code here. And then another little change here is that we don't manually call .backward on the loss anymore. We will use Fabric for that. So what we do is we do fabric.backward, and then we will provide the loss here as the input to that. And yeah, other than that, we have the same thing here. We just use fabric.device, get rid of these two lines of code here. And this should be it for the main function. Now, what we have to do is we have to use Fabric on our model, the optimizer, and the data sets. So going down to section 4 here, initializing the model, we will also initialize Fabric. So here we call the Fabric class. And what's nice is it accepts a lot of these arguments that you are already familiar with from the trainer. So we can use, for example, CUDA here to use our GPU. And if the machine has multiple GPUs, we can, let's say, use all the 4 GPUs in this particular machine I'm using. And then we can also specify the multi-GPU training strategy. Let's use DeepSpeed stage 2 here, which we already used in unit 9. So let's do that. And because it's also useful and speeds up the training by a lot, let's use mixed precision training as we have done in unit 9 as well. And with one line of code here, we can configure a lot of additional things, which is really nice. So there are a lot of more functions here that we can put in, but I will just reference the documentation in the website, the course website, so that I'm not overwhelming you here with too many options. The main options, I would say, though, are those where we use multiple GPUs and mixed precision training. So similar to what we did with the dot device on the batch, we can then also let Fabric take care of the model for us, so we don't have to manually put it on our GPU anymore. So instead, we will, I forgot one thing, we will first launch Fabric, and then we will use the setup functions for our model and the data loaders. So what that means now is that we are modifying the model and the optimizer, calling fabric.setup. And then we will provide the model and optimizer as input. And then we will do something similar with the data loader. So we have the train loader, the validation set loader, and the test loader. So we will also call Fabric here, but the function we want is setup data loaders. And Yeah, this will make it such that we don't have to worry about putting the data onto the devices, and it will automatically handle multiple GPUs and so forth without having us to worry about it. A little modification down here is to also use Fabric as we have defined earlier when we modified the main function above. Here the little change as well. And since we have Fabric now, we don't have to manually put that on our device, the GPU device anymore. And if I see it correctly, we are at the end of the script here, and these should be all the little modifications that we have to make. It's actually pretty little what we have to modify here, maybe 5 to 10 lines of code. I will share both the PyTorch version and the Fabric version so that you can also use, let's say, Visual Studio Code to look at them side by side, and you will see the modifications are really minimal. But again, this is really allowing us to access a lot of powerful functionality if we are given a PyTorch script. So let's actually now run this and see how fast that runs compared to before. So before it was 21 minutes on a single GPU. Now we are using 4 GPUs and mixed precision training, and I bet it will be much faster. Okay, I made a little typo here, as you can see. So let me go up here again. I should have typed mixed, of course. So a little typo. Let's try again. So yeah, it looks like the training just finished in 1 minute 0.7, which is pretty amazing.
So in this video, we learned how we can train a large language model using Fabric. And as you can see, there were only a few lines of code that we needed to change to go from plain PyTorch code to Fabric, which is pretty nice.